Hi friends, this is GODSON from GT Coding. In this tutorial, we will learn how to use Kadane's algorithm to find the maximum sum subarray. So this problem is basically to find a subarray which has the maximum sum. So for example, in this array we have the elements -2, -1, -3, -4, -1, -2, -1, -5, and -4. And if we take the subarray -2, -1, -3, we can see that we get the sum of -2, -1, and -3 as -4. And if we take the subarray 2 and 1, we see that we get the sum as 3. So in this way, we have to find out which subarray has the maximum sum. It can be the whole array or it can be just one item in the array. So we'll look at the algorithm. We have two parameters for the function. One is the array or the pointer of the first element of the array, and the next parameter is the length of the array. Now in that we have two variables, current max and max so far, which we will set to 0 in the beginning. Then we will iterate through the array using a for loop, and we will add the current item of the array to current max variable. If that becomes negative, then we set current max to 0 and we set max so far to current max if current max is greater than max so far. So in this way we iterate through the whole array and we can find the maximum sum subarray. So let's get started. We will first go to the first item of the array, that is -2, and compare and see whether -2 is less than 0. If that is so, we set current max to 0 and max so far will remain 0. Now we will go to the next element, 1. We can see that 1 is greater than 0, so we will set current max to 1 and current max is greater than max so far, so we will set max so far to current max, that is 1. Now we will go to the next element, -3. Now we can see that if we add current max, which is 1, to -3, we get the answer as -2, which is a negative number. So we again set current max to 0 and we will start again. We'll take the next item, that is 4. We can see that 4 is positive number, so we will set current max to 4, and max so far is less than current max. So we will set max so far to 4 as well. Now we'll go to the next item in the array, that is -1. If we add it, we get the sum as 3. So we'll set current max to 3. Now we don't have to change max so far because max so far is already greater than current max. So we'll move on to the next item in the array, that is 2, and we will add 2 to current max. We will get the answer as 5. We'll set current max to 5, and since max so far is lesser than current max, we'll set max so far to 5 as well. Now we'll move to the next element, that is 1, and we can see that 5 plus 1 is 6, so we set current max to 6. Max so far will become 6 as well. Now we'll add the next element, minus 5. So minus 6 minus 5 becomes 1. So we'll set current max to 1. Max so far remains the same. Now we'll add the last item of the array, that is 4. 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. We'll set current max to 5. And max so far remains 6. Now we can see that we got the answer as 6, which is the subarray 4, minus 1, 2, and 1. So this is how we find the maximum sum subarray using Kadane's algorithm. Okay, now we'll write the code for this program in C. First, we'll include the header file. Now we'll create the main function, int main void. In that, we'll create an array of integers. So these are the items in the array. Now we will include one more variable for storing the length of the array. Int n is equal to 9. Now the next thing that we'll do is create a variable for storing the answer, and we'll get that answer from a function called maxSum, which we'll create. So int answer is equal to maxSum, and in that we will pass two parameters. One is the first item of the array as the pointer, and the next parameter is the number of elements, that is n. So after that we'll print the answer. Maximum sum is answer. Okay, now we'll create the function maxSum. First of all, we'll declare it here, int maxSum, and two parameters, int star a, that is the first item of the array, and int n, that is the length of the array. Okay, now we'll write the function here, int maxSum, int star a, int n, and and that we'll create some variables. We'll create three variables. One is current sum, and the next variable we'll create is sum so far. Now we have to set current sum and sum so far to 0. So we'll do that. Current sum is equal to 0, and sum so far is equal to 0. So now we will iterate through the array for I is equal to 0 to n. Now first of all we will add the ith item in the array to the current sum. So we'll write current sum plus equal to a of I. Then we'll write an if condition. If current sum is less than 0, if current sum is a negative number, then we have to set current sum to 0. So if current sum is less than 0, write current sum is equal to 0. Or else, so here we'll write an if condition. So if the current sum is greater than sum so far, we will set sum so far to current sum. So here sum so far is equal to current sum. And that's all. Now we will return sum so far and we'll get the answer. Now let's compile the program. GCC maxSum.c. It has compiled. Now we will run the program. we should get the answer as 6. So we have got the answer, maximum is 6. Now in Kadane's algorithm, we can see that the array should contain at least one positive integer. So if the array does not contain any positive number, we have to make some changes to the algorithm. So for example, if you have the array as -2, -1, and -6 and the length is 3, then we should get the answer as -1, not as 0. If we use this algorithm, we will get the answer as 0, but we can make some changes and make this work for negative numbers as well. So for that we'll need to set current sum and sum so far to the first item of the array A0, and sum so far is equal to A0. Now we have to create one more variable for knowing whether all the elements in the array are negative or not. So we'll create a variable called negative and set it to 1. Now we will iterate through the array and check if there is at least one item in the array which is positive. So for I is equal to 0 to n, if ai is greater than 0 or greater than or equal to 0, what we'll do is set negative to 0 and break through the loop. Now here we will write a condition: if negative is equal to 1, we have to return the largest negative number. We will iterate through the loop. So sum so far, we will set sum so far to the greatest of ai or sum so far. So this basically does it. Now we will return sum so far, which is our answer. Now the whole code that we wrote here, we have to include it in the else block. So write else. That's all. We have modified the Kadane's algorithm to work with the negative numbers as well. Now we will check whether it works. GCC max sum dot c, it has compiled. Now we'll run the program. Now we have got the answer, that is -1. So I hope you have understood the problem. If you like this video, click on the like button. For more updates, subscribe to our channel. Thank you.